I'd like to go back across the panel just to talk about maybe what's the top one thing that contributes to success and what's the top one thing that contributes to failure in Google Summer of Code. What do you think, Diego?
Failure is lack of communication. If you're not available, you will, if you're not available either in IRC, IM, email, you don't make yourself visible, you will fail. That's been the number one thing that people have done when they fail. I've had a couple of students fail, and the other thing is, even if you fail, it doesn't mean that you lost. One of the students I had, and I think in the first or second year, he actually didn't complete Summer of Code, but he did stay as a GCC developer. So the project he started was obviously too big for what he thought it was going to be, but he liked it. He liked, you know, he liked working with GCC. He liked the area. And so he stayed after summer, midway through the program, he decided, no, I won't be able to complete this. But he did stay in the community. He stayed active, working with Bugzilla or fixing easy patches here and there. And, you know, right now he's one of GCC developers. So for us, that's a bigger success than a student that comes in April and is gone by September, because yep. we gain a developer.
I just want to add to that. Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, of the failures, project failures I've seen over the years, like 80% are just the person disappearing. The other 20% is actually not delivering. And like the first year I was running, there was this other student with Fedora that he promised to write a free like wireless driver for some kind of hardware, and that's an impressive project, but just impossible to do for someone new to kernel programming in the summer. So he failed, but he did get something running, but it was far from the spec, which was a fully functional driver. Now, over the years, the mentors have also learned how to negotiate better with the students before the program starts to be more realistic about it. And also the program has become more realistic. It allows like negotiating the expectation midterm and stuff, but it totally doesn't. But on the other hand, it doesn't help beefing up your application just to get accepted. It doesn't work that way. And the hardest part about Summer of Code, like selecting the students, I guess, is seeing through this proposal. I mean, it's not like we don't even see your grades. It's just we see a piece of text you wrote. And that's interesting. At Cairo last year, I had one of my maintainers review one of the applications, and I was sitting next to him. We were at a conference, and he was, oh, this is great. This proposal is so great. And after finishing the paragraph, he remembered that he actually wrote that paragraph in the ideas page. So someone just copied that. So that's a very common thing. I've seen that in GNOME too. That's the main problem with the list of ideas. So like the first year I ran, there was no list of project ideas. You were supposed to come up with your own idea and propose it. So one of the problems is to see through what you actually are proposing, what's yours, and if you really understand the extent of it. So it helps if you show us why, that you understand the problem first, and that you have the expertise to do the project. It can refer to older projects you have done, or I don't know, maybe a couple courses, relevant courses you have passed, or something like that. Actually, in GNOME this year, I guess we require some prior contribution to a project. It can be in the form of a patch to a bug in the Bugzilla or something like that. So we had to come up with something like this, because it's just so hard to, you get like 300 proposals from people all across the globe, and you don't know their school, you don't know their grades, you don't, it's just a piece of text, and they promise the best thing ever. You really want this feature, but the bigger the fish is, the less probable they actually deliver it.
That's the same as trying to hire somebody based on the resume in the first place.
Right, that's what you actually...
It's exactly the same.
Yeah, so, but you actually set up an... Yeah.